The video hasn't even started yet, and the flower has already fallen off. Hi Twilights, and welcome to a new video. Today I will be telling you a bit about the book that I'm writing. It's a book about my Beanie Boos. I've been working on writing it for quite some time now, I think a few months. But like when I write a book, I start writing it and then I don't write for a few days and then I don't write for a week and I don't write for a month and in the end I just stop writing it. I'm probably only on like 10% of all the writing that I need to do for this book, but it's more than I've ever had before. So that means that there is a chance that I'm actually going to finish this book. So what exactly is this book about, other than my Beanie Boos, you may ask? Well, it's not just about my Beanie Boos and describing them. It's more about the entire storyline. Since I was 9 or something, I created something like an imaginary world for all my Beanie Boos, in which my Beanie Boos had their own group and their own superpowers. The superpower of me, of Muffin, is that I have extremely fast reflexes. And in this book, it will also be kind of like about the superpowers, but it will also be about how this group tried to survive, how they managed to get a new home. They just had to fight for territory. It's kind of inspired by warrior cats. Yeah, here's kind of like a trailer or something like in the screen.
Kidding me.
We're used to this. We're very, very used to this. We know how many times it's happened before. Another thing, I'm not gonna like sell this book or anything. So it's not like this is kind of like commercial or something. It's kind of like a review. One page per Beanie Boo, in which there's some general information about the Beanie Boo. There's a picture and there's their name, of course, and there's what superpower they have, something they like. And also, I forgot about my own book, what the last thing was. And at the bottom of the page, there is a small story about the Beanie Boo. It's about half a page, a perspective of what happened in this Beanie Boo world from the perspective of that particular Beanie Boo. Whose page is on. 104 pages with Beanie Boos, because at this moment I have 104 Beanie Boos. So I have 104 pages. On every page there is one unique story in which that Beanie Boo gives their thoughts on what happened in their world. But it is chronological. For all the Beanie Boos, you follow that history when you're reading the book and the pages. So it's not like written like a book, but it's still written like a book. Woo! So this is all that I've written so far. Yeah, you can see that I made a template of every page, but only these ones, the highest ones, are the ones that I've already written. I'm going to be giving you a short preview of the first page. Get the cool lights, get the aesthetic. Is that the aesthetic flower that you're falling? Hello there. My name is Sandy. Wait, maybe I should get Sandy for this because now it's weird. Hello there. My name is Sandy. Some call me the very first member of Beanie Boo Town. That might not be exactly true though, because when I first traveled with a group, it was with multiple others. And the reason we all traveled together was far from fun. I and the others, Pinky, Slippery, and Slick, started out in a very dark environment. It were bad times for all of us, filled with anguish, and even death. I've seen so many sad things in my life, so many defeats and countless battles. But I also know that we escaped. We got away and we survived. I've seen how we managed to make a home together. I've seen the group grow from 4 to so many more members. In the darkest times, we looked out for one another. I experienced many more dangers, and I was so scared. But there were always others beside me, right at my side, or invisible beside me. I knew I was never alone. We were together,
in Beanie Boo Town. And there, we felt safe.
Well, yeah, as you can see, it's not kind of like a great... As you can see, it's not kind of like a very happy story. Well, it does have happy moments, and it is kind of like happy in the end. But like, there are also very, dark things in it. Just like with Warrior Cats, like, it's about living in a group and feeling safe, but also needing to survive it. And well, that's kind of like what the entire book is about.
La, la, la. Emotional, damn it!
I have no idea if this video was even interesting to watch, but I just wanted to make a video and I decided to update you guys on this project that I've been doing for a few months now. Also, I have an MEP called Everything Moves that I uploaded about half a year ago, and a lot of parts are already done and there are also a few open parts. So if you are interested in making MEP parts, please check it out. The link is in the description. That was the video. Bye, Twilight!